star performance of a poem first published in 1829. It's a cautionary tale about the dangers of the smooth talker, the flatterer, the charmer, and the cunning predator. Written by Mary Howitt, The Spider and the Fly.
Walk into my parlour,
said the spider to the fly.
'Tis the prettiest little parlour that ever you did spy. The way into my parlour is up a winding stair, and I've many curious things to show when you are there.
Oh, no, no,
said the little fly.
To ask me is in vain. So who goes up your winding stair? Can never come down again.
Oh, I'm sure you must be weary, dear, soaring up so high. You rest upon my little bed,
said the spider to the fly.
There are pretty curtains drawn around. The sheets are fine and thin. And if you'd like to rest a while, I'll snugly tuck you in.
Oh, no, no,
said the little fly.
For I've often heard it said, they never, never wake again who sleep upon your bed.
Said the cunning spider to the fly.
Dear friend, what can I do to prove the warm affection I've always felt for you? I have within my pantry good store of all that's nice. I'm sure you're very welcome. You pleased to take a slice?
Oh, no, no,
said the little fly.
Kind sir, that cannot be. I've heard what's in your pantry, and I do not wish to see.
Sweet creature,
said the spider.
You're witty, and you're wise. How handsome are your rosy wings. How brilliant. I have a little looking glass upon my parlour shelf. If you'll step in one moment, dear, you shall behold yourself.
I thank you, gentle sir,
she said,
for what you're pleased to say. And bidding you good morning now, I'll call another day.
The spider turned him round about and went into his den. But when he knew the silly fly would soon come back again. So he wove his subtle web in a little corner sly and set his table ready to dine upon the fly. Then he came out to his door again and merrily did sing.
Come hither, hither, pretty fly with a pearl and silver wing. Your robes are green and purple, and a crest upon your head. Your eyes are like the diamond bright, but mine are dull as lead.
Alas, alas, how very soon this silly little fly, hearing his wily, flattering words, comes slowly flitting by. With buzzing wing, she hung aloft, then near and nearer drew, thinking only of her brilliant eyes and green and purple hue, thinking only of her crested head. Poor foolish thing, at last up jumped the cunning spider and fiercely held her fast. He dragged her to his winding stair, into his dismal den, within his little parlour. Blair came out again. And now, dear little children, who may this story lead? To idle, silly, flattering words, I pray you never give heed. And to an evil counsellor, close heart and ear and eye, and take a lesson from this story of the spider and the fly.